Can you describe a little bit of what life was like inside your cell?
At the PNP custodial center, it's a strict regulation that there will be, that cell phones are prohibited. These are contraband. So I did not have a cell phone. I never get to use cell phone in my more than 6 years of detention there. I also do not have a television, although I have, just like the other detainees, we have movie viewing privileges once a week. I have every Saturday movie viewing schedule on TV, but I'm not able to. I was not able to watch news on TV. Yeah. So these are considered contraband.
No access to the internet.
I have no access. I had no access to the internet. I don't have laptop. I don't have any other electronic gadget. So I've just relearned using my cell phone the other night. Nagkakamali-mali pa kang ako, hindi ko pa alam yung sa Viber, sa Telegram. It's just really the SMS.
Yes. So you don't know Viber? I mean, this is, wow. Okay, go on. Yeah. All right.
So my assistant is trying to teach me.
Yeah.
But I can send messages now, and of course accept messages and make calls, but not yet Viber. In Telegram, I tried it already since yesterday, but not yet Viber. And let alone, I have not tried yet tweet, because my tweets before, I do it by handwriting the text of my tweet, and then I send it out. It's up, and it was up for my staff to encode them and to send it.
Yeah. Well, now Twitter has a new name. I mean, even that changed, right? No, it's just amazing that in this modern era, you have a figure like yourself, right? Nobody can picture 7 years. Now, people deprived of liberty, if they're convicted and they're guilty, is another thing. But in this case, you were detained, witnesses recanted, you are innocent of the charges, right? You have, two of the cases have been dismissed. You have one last that's already pending. How did you keep, frankly, you talked about your sanity. Oh. And I was thinking, what if I were in your position? How would the grace, the strength, how would it be? How did you deal with that, Senator, that frankly, you came out, you're still laughing now? You know, you're not bitter. How did you do it?
That's why I had to develop my daily routine. It's a strict daily routine. And of course, prayers. The best weapon is always prayers. And every day I really prayed. I read the Bible. I had personal reflections, contemplative readings. I do the physical chores in my compound. I feed the cats. I feed the chickens. I talk to the cats. They became so attached to me, and that's why I miss them so much. And even now, if I think about them, I'm so saddened that I cannot bring them all. I had to choose only my favorites. And I had to bring them sa bahay ko po, yung mga favorite cats ko, but not all. If only I could bring them all, I would. But it's not possible for me. So developing a daily routine, I just needed to be busy all the time. Of